Well, in this city update, I'm joined today by Lee Jernigan. He's the city's traffic engineer, and we're talking about some of the changes that are going into effect soon in the downtown parking. So now we're going to be implementing paid parking in the downtown footprint, and that's going to be starting on
April 1st.
All right, and so we have some kiosks that are going to be coming in the next few weeks. Tell me a little bit about the kiosks.
Yes, sir. So, Gavin, we have 34 pay kiosks that'll be located in various areas around downtown. 28 will be on-street locations, and 6 will be in our off-street city-owned parking lots.
All right, and how do these kiosks function? So,
well, they're very similar to kiosks you may see in any other city. So you'll approach the kiosk, you'll wake it up, as we say, and just follow the prompts along the screen. One important thing to remember as you're paying in this program is everything is tracked by your license plate. So all folks need to make sure they remember their license plate. So once you're prompted to pay, you will enter your license plate, and that's how it knows that your vehicle is paid for ever how long parking you need.
And so the kiosks are about every block or so?
Roughly a block and a half. Like I say, it's just paid within our core downtown area, and so it's pretty saturated with kiosks.
Now, when you pay, is that for just one block area, or is that in the whole downtown area?
Well, it's actually for that whole core footprint. So if you pay for an hour's worth of parking, you're good to move from space to space within that footprint, as long as you've paid for the amount of time you need. So if you need to make a quick trip and park for a few minutes and move down and do another errand, you're still able to do that as long as you've paid for that hour's worth of parking.
And the kiosks aren't the only way that you can pay for your downtown parking.
That's correct. The kiosk, as you mentioned, accepts coins, bills, credit cards, debit cards, but virtually all methods of payment. But another method that you mentioned is our app payment, and that's Park Mobile. It's a very popular app that's used in a lot of municipalities around North Carolina and the United States. So just go download that Park Mobile app on your phone. You can set up your account information and just pay using your smartphone.
And I guess that makes it a lot easier for the drivers too, because then they don't have to remember their license plate or anything like that. They can just go into the app, authorize their payment, and go on with their business.
That's correct. As well as the app will advise you if your parking is getting ready to expire. So in other words, if you paid for an hour's worth of parking and you get caught up running your errands a little longer than what you thought, it will actually prompt you back on your smartphone to say, hey, your parking is getting ready to expire. Would you like to increase your time? And so that's another useful tool.
So is it 1 hour blocks?
It's 1 hour blocks, typically. Council approved a rate to allow within the first hour folks could pay for just 30 minutes. So as opposed to being required to pay the $1 for a whole hour, say if you're just making a quick trip, you will be allowed to pay for 30 minutes at the rate of 50 cents, but that's only during your first hour. So once that first hour, you would be required to pay an hour blocks.
Well, and that brings up a good point. What are the rates and hours for the enforcement of the parking?
Okay, so our on-street or enforcement of the program will be from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Monday through Friday. And those rates during those times are $1 an hour on street with no maximum. So theoretically, you could park that entire time as long as you continue to pay your dollar per hour rate. Our off-street lots are $1 per hour with a $5 daily maximum. And all those are outside of any special event rates that may be in place during, for example, Woodpecker baseball games, which those rates would be $5 in our off-street lots.
Automatically, and that goes for weekends as well, if you're gonna be in the off-street lots for the games and that sort of thing.
That's correct. Even though their enforcement is not going on Saturdays or Sundays, if there's a Woodpecker game or another special event, the $5 special event fee could still be in effect.
Okay, excellent. And I know there's a lot of information that we've been sharing. So we do have a website where a lot of this information is there. That's going to be fayettevillenc.gov/downtownparking. And I understand we got a new website that's under development. And so
that's
once
correct.
It goes live, that our city's website is going to redirect, will automatically push you to the new website. So you just got to remember that. Be sure to check in on often. Now, when are all these effects going? When is everything going into effect? What's that start date?
Well, the start date is April 1st. Between now and April 1st, there's going to be a lot of activity in the downtown area. So folks, be aware of those changes. You'll see a lot of signing that'll be going up. You'll see construction of the kiosk and the installation of the kiosk. So in the next 2 to 3 weeks, there'll be a lot of changes ongoing downtown as we transition to this new program.
All right. Well, thank you, Lee, for coming on to this city update and giving us all this information. And I want to thank you for watching.